Hello everyone, welcome to Arpita Sharma classes. This is part 5 of Parliament, chapter Parliament of Indian Polity that we are completing. Now so far we are going to revise what we have covered so far. Abhi tak humne jo bhi cover kiya usko hum revise karenge, theek hai? We have studied that India has a parliamentary system of government and Union Parliament is the supreme legislative body in the country, that also we have studied. Now you have to remember that Indian Parliament is bicameral legislature. That means it has two houses, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. Over here you can see our legislature is bicameral. Parliament has two organs, three organs basically, legislature, executive and president. And in the legislature it's bicameral. That means it is comprised of two houses, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. Now Lok Sabha is known as House of People. Lok means people, House of People. They are directly elected by people through the voting process. Now, in Rajya Sabha, which is known as Council of States, here the members are elected by the members of state legislative assemblies. Okay? So, Parliament consists of two houses and the President. President is the head of state. Now, Prime Minister is a part of executive organ and Prime Minister is head of government. Head of state is President, head of government is Prime Minister. Then in executive, we have administrative machineries of IAS, IPS, IRS, civil servants, cabinet ministers, and they are known as government. All right. And government is accountable to Lok Sabha because people have, you know, voted them. Na? So that is why they are accountable, they are answerable to Lok Sabha. And Lok Sabha could initiate non-confidence motion against the government. That also we have studied in the motions class. That is part 4 of Parliament. Okay. Now, always remember, legislature and executive, they are not separate from each other. Okay? They are interlinked with each other through the system of checks and balances. Okay? I write it down, checks and balances. This is the system through which both are interconnected with each other. And Indian parliamentary system, you know, finds its origin in the Westminster system. Jo UK ka Westminster system hai, wahan se humne isko parliament system ko liya hai. We have studied three kinds of functions of parliament also, legislative function, then we studied the executive functions and we studied the financial functions. In the executive functions, we studied about the motions. Financial functions mein, parliament is the ultimate authority when it comes to finances. So executive cannot spend a single pie without parliamentary approval. For that we have our union budget. Uske liye hamare paas aata hai hamara union budget, which is prepared by the cabinet. And it is submitted for approval to the parliament. Parliament mein approval ke liye submit kiya jata hai. So all proposals to impose taxes should also be approved by parliament. Now there are two kinds of standing committees. Please write it down. Standing committees mein bhi do kinds hote hain, do prakar hote hain, jo aapko yaad rakhne hain. Okay? First is known as the Public Accounts Committee, PAC. Public Accounts and Estimates Committee. Okay? So there are two standing committees, Public Accounts Committee and Estimates Committee. Ek to Public Account Committee ho gayi aur ek Estimate Committee ho gayi. I'll write the full form also. First is the Public Committee, second is Public Account Committee, second is the Estimates Committee. These are the two standing committees that you have to remember. You know, they are a part of Parliament to keep a check on how the executive is spending the money which is given to it by the legislature. Okay? And we have studied the functions of parliament also, amending functions, electoral functions, judicial functions, that also we have studied. Now, another question is, what is the role of parliament in lawmaking? So you have to remember that parliament makes laws for the whole country. It can also amend the constitution or reject or change the draft laws. And how does parliament make laws? A bill becomes a law after it is passed by both the houses of parliament, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. And then it receives presidential permission also. Then it becomes law. Alright. Now let us understand another important point. Ek aur point padhte hain, that parliament's power of passing laws on items which are mentioned in the state list. Unacademy is providing 3 months free extension on 1 year and above plus GSN plus combo subscriptions. This offer is valid only till 30th November. Also, if you take a 1 year or more subscription of combo on Unacademy Plus, that is GS Plus optional subscription, you will be getting huge discounts from Unacademy. We are providing 25% discount with optional, 10% discount if you use the referral code ARPITA10 and flat 2500 off on your Plus subscription. This offer again is valid with the combo subscription till 30th November. So make sure that you take your subscription today because the batches are starting from 1st of December 2021 for 2022 and 23 aspirants. Make sure that you take your subscription and prepare and boost up your preparation with Unacademy Plus. The links are given below in the description box. Now, when it comes to Parliament's power to pass laws on items in the state list, it can be done under these situations. Okay? It can be done under these situations. तो ये चार सिचुएशंस हैं जिसमें पार्लियामेंट जो है वो स्टेट सब्जेक्ट्स जो होते हैं, स्टेट लिस्ट में जो सब्जेक्ट हैं, उनके ऊपर भी लॉ बना सकता है. ठीक है, आर्टिकल 356, दैट इज एमरजेंसी. इफ एमरजेंसी इज इन ऑपरेशन ऑन इन एनी स्टेट और द स्टेट इज अंडर प्रेसिडेंट्स रूल, देन द पार्लियामेंट कैन इनैक्ट लॉज ऑन आइटम्स इन द स्टेट लिस्ट ऑल्सो. देन आर्टिकल 249, Parliament can make laws on items in the state list if Rajya Sabha passes a resolution by 2/3 majority of its members which are present and voting, that it is necessary for Parliament to make laws in the, on the subjects which are listed in state list. तो अगर state राज्य सभा के जो 2/3 majority है वो ये resolution pass कर दे कि yes Parliament को इस particular subject पर जो स्टेट लिस्ट में मेंशन है इस पे लॉ बनाना चाहिए, तो पार्लियामेंट उस सब्जेक्ट पे लॉ बना देगा. ठीक है, आर्टिकल 253, इट कैन पास लॉज ऑन स्टेट लिस्ट आइटम्स इफ इट इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ इंटरनेशनल अग्रीमेंट्स. अगर इंटरनेशनल अग्रीमेंट्स की इंप्लीमेंटेशन के लिए जरूरी है कि पार्लियामेंट लॉ बनाए स्टेट सब्जेक्ट्स पर, तब 253 आर्टिकल यूज होगा. And Article 252, if legislature of two or more states pass a resolution to effect that it is desirable, it is necessary to have a parliamentary law on any item listed in state list, then Parliament can make laws for those states. तो अगर दो या दो से ज़्यादा state जो है वो मिलकर resolution pass करें कि yes Parliament के द्वारा law बनाना ज़रूरी है state list के subject पर, तब वो चीज़ हो सकती है. ठीक है, सो दीज आर द फोर आर्टिकल्स और फोर सर्कमस्टांसेस वेयर पार्लियामेंट कैन मेक लॉज ऑन द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ स्टेट लिस्ट. सो दिस वॉज द समरी ऑफ व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड सो फार.